Foreign Secretary Sri Vijay Gokhaleji, Dean of the Foreign Service Institute Sri J.S. Mukulji, Officer Trainees, I warmly welcome you all to Rashtrapati Bhavan. It is always a pleasure for me to interact with our youth, and more so when they happen to be the ones ready to enhance our external relations and contribute to the nation building. I congratulate you on joining the Indian Foreign Service and the two officer trainees from Bhutan, the Royal Bhutan Foreign Service. It is indeed a privilege to represent one's country. This privilege entails a deep commitment from you to serve the people of India. I hope you will attend to this higher call of the duty with pride, humility, and dedication. I am happy that as a group, you represent India's diversity in every sense of the term. It is equally satisfying that we continue to see greater gender balance in the newer batches of the Indian Foreign Service. These bode well for the service and our nation. Dear officer trainees, you have had an intensive six-month training at the Foreign Service Institute. It has given you an all-round exposure to the political, economic, and cultural facets of India. You have learned of our national interests and its linkages with the outside world, of our hard power options and soft power influence, of our expansive global agenda, and of the geopolitical complexities facing us. You have honed your skills and are all set to march on. You are among the best and the brightest in the country, and now you have to prove that you are the best and brightest in the art of diplomacy as well. There could not be a better time to join the Indian Foreign Service. India's role and influence in the international arena is expanding. Geopolitics and geoeconomics are drawing Asia at the center of global power relations. And in this matrix, India has an important role to play as a driver of global growth and as an influential voice in global governance. We are living in an age of rapid changes. As a country, we have taken 70 years to become an economy of US$2.5 trillion. But would take just 7 years to double this figure. If this be the projection, you can imagine the scale of responsibility you are going to have before you. To foster peace and stability, to scout for investments, to look for technology partnerships, to secure new markets, and to create frameworks to tackle conventional and non-conventional threats from cybersecurity to energy security and more so. Dear officer trainees, hum sab log jante hain ki desh ke hiton ki raksha karna aur Bharat ki sakaratmak chhavi prastut karna videsh mein kaar karte samay aapka pramukh daitva hai. Saath hi aapki utni hi aham zimmedari bhi hai ki desh mein dharatal se jude vikas aur pragati ko bhi aap protsahan dein. उदाहरण के लिए यदि किसानों की आय को बढ़ाना हमारा लक्ष्य है तो आपको अपनी निष्ठा और परिश्रम से निर्यात के लिए नए बाजार तलाशने होंगे. इसी प्रकार यदि हमें विश्व स्तर की हाई स्पीड ट्रेन का निर्माण करना है तो आपको प्राथमिकता के तौर पर वित्त और टेक्नोलॉजी से जुड़ी वैश्विक संस्थाओं के साथ मिलकर काम करना होगा. भारत की प्रगति और समृद्धि में अन्य सिविल सेवाओं के साथ आपका योगदान भी अहम है. अलॉन्ग विथ फास्टरिंग डेवलपमेंट वी हैव ब्रॉट एंगेजमेंट विद अवर डायस्पोरा एट द सेंटर ऑफ अवर एक्सटर्नल रिलेशंस. दिस ईयर वी आर सेलिब्रेटिंग द 150th बर्थ एनिवर्सरी ऑफ महात्मा गांधी, अवर ग्रेटेस्ट प्रवासी. In his struggle overseas, he relentlessly fought for the welfare of our people. Gandhiji should be an inspiration for you as you work to serve our community abroad. In my visits overseas, I have given high priority to meeting our brothers and sisters abroad. Our External Affairs Minister, as you all know, has done exceptional work to make our consular duty and community outreach service-oriented. She has provided human touch to public service. This has received appreciation from far and wide, and so has the work of our missions, who have been sensitive to the needs of our people. As professional diplomats, you must develop an attitude and mindset of serving our people. At times, you may be required to go that extra mile to give them a helping hand. Such sensitivity and human approach in your work will go a long way in enhancing our public service delivery. I would also urge you to regularly meet our community members and look after their welfare. I have paid state visits to several countries, and I wish to share some of my experiences with you. Today, the international community indeed has greater appreciation of India and its global standing. Leaders from across the world are keen to visit India and strengthen bilateral ties with us. Nations are looking for solutions to global challenges from us, be it climate change, cybersecurity, humanitarian disasters, or combating extremism and terrorism. These open unprecedented opportunities, but also pose new challenges for our diplomacy. In such a scenario, as a country and as diplomats, we must bring strategic thinking at the center of our working more than ever before. Thinking into the future and looking at the world holistically will help us anchor our interests better. I also experienced firsthand the value that communication and use of cultural idiom bring to our external engagement. You talk to your interlocutor in his or her language, and you see an instant connect developing. I understand you will shortly be leaving for your language posting. Do your best to master the languages you would be studying. On my visits abroad, I have had the opportunity to see how well some of your colleagues have done to achieve higher levels of specialization in foreign languages. They make us proud. I encourage you to follow them and do even better. And along with language skills, you must also be open to embracing cultures, peoples, and technology. These skills and sensibilities will unlock a whole new world for you. As you all know, we have two distinguished officer trainees from Bhutan. To them, I wish to say we take great pride in India-Bhutan friendship. I hope the interaction and engagement you have had with your course mates will further strengthen our unique and special friendship. To the IFS trainee officers, I would say that you are members of a very distinguished service. The IFS has brought us many achievements. The high responsibility of strengthening our bilateral relations and global partnerships with countries rests on you. In this endeavor, you have to deepen political and security engagement, expand trade and economic collaboration, and foster closer people-to-people relations. I am convinced that you will work with dedication and with integrity and honesty to bring greater peace and prosperity to the country. And while you do so, I urge you to be ever empathetic to those you serve, especially the less privileged. The people of India have high expectations from you, and you must live up to them. I wish you success in your career ahead. Thank you. Jai Hind.